Good morning, everyone, and welcome back. So today's a little bit of a departure from electronics. Going to have a look at a Raspberry Pi today and just cover off on getting it set up with the operating system from scratch. So let's take a look at it now. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to want to do is head over to the Raspberry Pi website. And if we just go to the downloads, the one we'll install today is going to be the Noobs. So just select Noobs. And I downloaded the zip file, which seemed to work really well for me. This takes an age. Okay, so first we need to prep the SD card. I used SD card formatter for this, and I'll put a link in down below, but basically just select the card and format it. Okay, so now we've got a card that's freshly formatted and ready to go. If you've downloaded the files and they're unzipped like this, then just copy them across into the root of that card. This also takes quite some time, but once that's copied across, we're good to go. Okay, so once the card's ready, insert it into the Raspberry Pi and turn it on. It'll come up with a menu asking you what you want to do. So what we want to do is select the operating system and hit install and confirm. And this will actually start the process of installing the OS on the Raspberry Pi. And again, this also takes quite some time. At the end of it, hit the reboot. And all things being well, you'll be greeted with the desktop. Okay, so there you go, we've actually got the OS installed. Now, a little bit of housekeeping. The first thing we want to do is get this thing on the internet. So I'm connecting it to my Wi-Fi. So just select the network and join to it. And once we've got that, we can start getting to work on it. So the first thing we want to do is check and see if there's any updates that need to be installed. So we do this with sudo apt-get. Update. So once that's finished, we then do sudo apt-get upgrade to actually install the updates and just confirm yes to do that. This takes quite some time as well, depending on how many updates there are. Now that all the packages are installed, let's grab the IP address by typing ifconfig and just document that because we'll use that later. So next, go up to the main menu, click on the Raspberry, scroll down to preferences and click on Raspberry Pi configuration. Sorry about the quality here, but if you just select interfaces and click enabled next to SSH to start off with, and then select localization, set locale, and set it appropriate to your region. And then select time zone and set that appropriately as well. And then select keyboard and just check that that's right and change it if required. And lastly, just set the country for your Wi-Fi. And once that's done, just click OK to close that dialog, and if it asks you to reboot, just confirm that and allow it to reboot. And when that comes back up, it'll ask you to change password because you've enabled SSH, so please do that now. So now the operating system's up and running, let's see if we can connect with SSH. I'll be using Terminal on the Mac, but you may want to use PUTTY on Windows. I'll put a link down below for that. So what you'll want to do is type SSH, then the username, which is pi at, and then the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. And because it's the first time it's connected to this device, it'll ask to sort out some security. So just confirm yes. So now we're connected to the Raspberry Pi. Let's type ls and see if we can bring up the home directory. And there it is, no problem. Okay, well there you go, that's got the basic operating system on the Raspberry Pi, and now it's time to start doing things with it. So in some later videos, we'll take a look at what we can do with it. Okay, cheers for now. If you like what I'm doing, then please do like the video. If you'd like to see more, then please subscribe, and don't forget to hit the chime so you get notified when I post something new. And I'll put a couple of links here to some other videos you can look at.